Hello friends, welcome to Affairs Cloud, we learn to lead. My name is Vikas. So friends, in this video we'll be discussing some of the famous personality who passed away in the January month. All these personalities are very important, so you need to know some of the information related to them. Do watch the video till the end, you will be getting a lot of information about these personalities. Hope you have subscribed to our channel. Hit the like button and share the link of this video with your friends. So let's start with our video. But before that, we have something important information to tell you about. We have an app by the name Careers Cloud, which you can go and download through the Play Store. Once you have downloaded the app, you will open the app and you'll see this type of screen. In this, you can go and log in with your Google account, that is your Gmail ID. Then once you have logged in, then you will be moved to this page where you can see a window. If you click on the current affairs section here, then you will be moved to this page. Now, this is where magic happens. This is the course where there are two courses provided by us. First, you should know it is of 1 year and 2 years. So choose your course accordingly. What we are providing and what is the reason behind that you should purchase course of current affairs from us, and what are the important details about it? First thing you should know that we provide you current affairs in both English and Hindi. Okay. Also, we provide you here current affairs daily. PDFs are provided daily. The important factor here to remember is we are providing PDF to you daily. Okay. That contains question answers of the daily current affairs. They are explained in a much easy way where you can grasp the knowledge and do your revision. Okay, apart from that, we provide you with question answers. Then on every day we provide you 20 question answers quiz, daily 20 questions quiz. So imagine how much it will benefit you in your preparation. Then we provide you same thing for weekly. In weekly we take a quiz of 50 questions. Then question answers of week, we provide you a book, a PDF is provided you weekly of the compiled questions of the whole week. Similarly for monthly also, ebook is given, your quizzes are taken, question answers PDF. Then apart from it, we also help you to prepare for banking papers. All the banking exams you can go refer to our videos and our courses here. You can see here that we provide you banking and economic quiz of 157 questions. Okay, then topic wise PDFs are covered. As you can see, we are making videos on indexes and reports, important days, the books and authors, all the events that are taking place in individual months. So these PDFs are provided to you and they will help you a lot in your preparation for journal awareness, your journal studies, as well as for current affairs. Then you can see we also provide you current affairs for state wise current affairs are provided to you. Apart from this, I have a gift for all of my friends here. If you use my code VIKAS10, you will be getting a straight 10% discount on the purchase you make. So when you are about to check out and do the payment, just before the payment, you will be getting an option to use the promo code. There you can put the VIKAS10, the code, and you will be getting an extra 10% discount on the total purchase you make there. So let's start with our video. So the first person we'll be discussing is John F. Reid. John F. Reid is related to sports cricket. He was a batsman and he was related to New Zealand's cricket team, or he belonged to the New Zealand country. The questions will be framed in such a manner that, first question, John F. Reid, he belonged to which sport? The question will be, John F. Reid belonged to which sport recently passed away? He belonged to cricket. First question. Alright, that too. Then next question. He belonged to which country? He belonged to New Zealand. Alright, I repeat, he belonged to New Zealand. Let me correct it. Then, in cricket also, he was a batsman of New Zealand cricket team. Another name. New Zealand is the country, but the question can also be framed like, which country did he play cricket for? He played cricket for New Zealand. Alright. Then he used to also captain the team during the test matches. Alright. He used to captain the New Zealand cricket team during the test matches. He is the person, as you can see in the picture, John F. Reid. He was a former New Zealand batsman and he belonged to cricket. Then if we look read some points regarding him, John Reid, former New Zealand cricketer, passed away at the age of 64 after a long illness. All right, he was from New Zealand. The left-handed batsman was born in Auckland City in the New Zealand, and he served as the New Zealand Test captain. All right, that means during the Test matches, he used to captain the New Zealand's cricket team. He is the person, as you can see in the picture. Then moving on to the next. Next, we'll be discussing, and this is an important question that can have the higher chance of being asked. Next is your Michael Kindo. Michael Kindo is a former Indian hockey player. He won Olympic bronze medalist in 1972 that was played in Munich. I repeat, he is a former Indian hockey player. He won Olympic bronze medal in 1972 that was held in Munich. He was also the part of Indian hockey team that won World Cup in 1975 that was held in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. And he is also a Arjuna Awardee winner in 1972. They also, and the important question that will be framed from this Arjuna Award itself, that he was the first sport person from the tribal background to win this, or he was the first sports person from tribal background to be awarded with Arjuna Award in 1972. So if we talk about Michael Kindo, he is related to which sport? He is related to hockey. All right, then he won bronze medal where in Olympics? That was held in 1972, and it was held in where? It was held in Munich. All right, then he was also the part of Indian hockey team that won the World Cup. Hockey World Cup in 1975 that was held in Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur. All right, then next, he became the first sportsperson from tribal background to win Arjuna Award. All right, this is one of the most important point to you have to remember. First, the question will be, who is the first sportsperson from the tribal background that was awarded with Arjuna Award? All right, and the name, and he is Michael Kindo. All right, and he was awarded with Arjuna Award in 1972. All right, so if we look at some of the points, the former Indian hockey player, Olympic bronze medalist Michael Kindo, passed away at the age of 73 due to age related ailments in Odisha. He belonged from Odisha state itself. Michael Kindo was a part of Indian hockey team which won the Olympic bronze medal in the Munich 1972 Olympic. He was also part of Indian team that won the 1975 Hockey World Cup that was held in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. This was the only time Indian won the World Cup in hockey. Then Michael Kindo also received the Arjuna Award in 1972 and became the first sport person of the tribal background to receive the Arjuna Award. All right, so this is the important point that you have to remember. Once again, see the picture of Michael Kindo ji. All right, so he is from hockey and he won bronze medal in Olympics in 1972. He won the World Cup, or Indian won the World Cup in 1975, Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur. And he is the first sport person from the tribal background to win or to receive Arjuna Award in 1972. Next, we'll be looking at a senior Indian Congress leader and our former Home Minister, Bhoota Singh ji. He was also the governor of Bihar. All right, Bhoota Singh, he's a senior leader of Indian National Congress, former Home Minister, and he was an 8-time Lok Sabha member of Parliament, and he was also as the governor of Bihar. He was in public service for a long time and served under 4 Prime Minister. He was born in Jalandhar district, Punjab, British India. Next question. Next person that we'll be discussing, this, he is very important. Mark this, very important. Ace Mountaineer Colonel Narendra Kumar. I repeat, Ace Mountaineer Colonel Narendra Kumar passes away. All right. He has also named as Bull. It is also Colonel Narendra Kumar is also known by the name Bull. The question that will be framed from this is that he played vital role in securing Siachen Glacier for India. I repeat and note this down, that who is the person that played vital role in securing Siachen Glacier for India? He is Narendra Kumar, or Colonel Narendra Kumar. He was the first Indian to climb Mount Nanda Devi, and in 1964 and in 1965 he climbed Mount Everest. So if we look at some of the questions that will be framed, is Colonel Narendra Kumar. He is also known by the name Bull. He played vital role in securing the Siachen Glacier. Alright. Then next thing, he was the first person to climb, or the first Indian to climb Mount Nanda Devi. When did he climb Mount Nanda Devi? It was in 1964, and in 1965 he climbed Mount Everest. Alright, so Colonel Narendra Kumar, as you can see in the picture, he's an ace mountaineer and he played vital role in securing Siachen Glacier for India. Let's read some of the points regarding him. Also remember, he's a Padma Shri awardee. Yes, Padma Shri awardee Colonel Narendra Kumar, an iconic mountaineer who played a vital role in securing Siachen Glacier for India, passed away at the age of 87 in Delhi. He was born on 8 December 1933 in Rawalpindi, now in Pakistan. He was the first Indian to climb Mount Nanda Devi. He climbed Mount Everest in 1965, and later he climbed Mount Kanchenjunga also. Next we'll be discussing Sahitya Academy winner A. Madhavanji. I repeat, Sahitya Academy winner A. Madhavanji. He was a Tamil writer. These are the two questions that can be framed from him. Alright, I repeat. A. Madhavanji. So, he is a Sahitya Academy winner. Alright, he received Sahitya Academy Award for Tamil writer. Alright, the question can also be framed like, he is related to which language? He is a writer of which language? He is a Tamil writer. Okay, A. Madhavan, you can see in the picture. These are the two questions that can be framed from him. Tamil writer A. Madhavan, who is a recipient of Sahitya Academy Award 2015, passed away at the age of 86 in Trivandrum, Kerala. He served as the member of expert committee of Sahitya Academy and also was the founder and president of Trivandrum Tamil Sangam. Alright, so just to remember these two points regarding A. Madhavanji, that he was a recipient of Sahitya Academy winner and also a Tamil writer. Remember this language, that question will be framed like, he belonged from which language, or he was a writer of which language? He was of Tamil. Alright, next we'll be talking about Pulitzer Prize winner and an author, Neil Sheehan. First of all, tell me, Pulitzer Prize related to which field? Pulitzer Prize is given in the field of journalism. Alright, I repeat, Pulitzer Prize is given in the field of journalism. So, Pulitzer Prize winner and an author, Neil Sheehan, passed away. Neil Sheehan. He was a Pulitzer Prize winner. Alright, remember, and this Pulitzer Prize is given in the field of journalism. Alright, so Neil Sheehan, Pulitzer Prize winner, passed away recently. Pulitzer Prize is given in the field of journalism. Neil Sheehan, an American journalist, Pulitzer Prize winning author, passed away at the age of 84 in Washington DC in United States of America. And he was, the reason of his death was Parkinson's disease. He was born in 1936 in Massachusetts, USA. So you can see in this picture, he is Neil Sheehan and a Pulitzer Prize winner. The question will be framed in such a way that recently a famous Pulitzer Prize winner from USA passed away. Name of the person is Neil Sheehan. Next is also an important question, actually very important question. So do take a note of this. Renowned astrophysicist and a mathematician, Professor passed away recently, whose name is Shashi Kumar Chitreji. I repeat, Shashi Kumar Chatriya ji. Another question related to him will be from, he was a recipient of which Padma award? He was a recipient of Padma Bhushan. All right. So if we look at Shashi Kumar Chatriya ji. Shashi Kumar Chatriya ji. He is a renowned astrophysicist and mathematician. All right, then he was a recipient of which Padma award? This is the question that will be framed, and it is Padma Bhushan. All right, he was a recipient of Padma Bhushan. Professor Shashi Kumar Chitre, globally renowned astrophysicist and mathematician, passed away at the age of 84 in Mumbai, Maharashtra. He was a recipient of Padma Bhushan. All right, and he retired as a senior professor from Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai, 2001. I repeat, he retired as a professor from which institute? Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Next, mark this question also very, this is very, very, very important question of January. All right, Padma Shri awardee D. Prakash Rao dies. D. Prakash Rao was a social worker. He was a recipient of Padma Shri, and he received Padma Shri in 2019 for his contribution towards boosting education among slum and orphan kids in Odisha. All right, I repeat, Padma Shri awardee in 2019 for his contribution towards boosting education among slum and orphan kids of Odisha Cuttack. He started Asha O Ashwana. Asha O Ashwana is a school for primary to third class students to give education to orphan and the slum area students. He used to sell tea, and the savings he used to make from selling the tea goes directly to Asha O Ashwana, that is the school for children. All right, so if we look at D. Prakash Rao, he is a social worker. He was a Padma Shri recipient. Means question, this can, nowadays question is not directly asked. The question can be asked here is, D. Prakash Rao was a Padma Shri awardee. He received Padma Shri award in which field? So he is related to social worker. That means he got Padma Shri for his social work. All right, such questions can also be framed. So he received Padma Shri award in 2019 for his education, means for his value of education among, or his work towards education for slum and orphan kids of Cuttack, Odisha. All right, he started a school by the name Asha O Ash Vasna. All right, Asha O Ash Vasna, this is the name of the school that was started by him. This is from primary to third class. All right, he was a tea seller, and all the earnings that he used to make from tea selling directly used to go to his school for the education of this orphan and slum children's. All right, so if we look at some of the key points, D. Prakash Rao, Padma Shri awardee and a renowned social worker, passed away in Cuttack, Odisha due to brain stroke. Prakash Rao hails from Cuttack, Odisha. D. Prakash Rao was conferred with Padma Shri in 2019 to recognize his contribution toward boosting the value of education among slum and orphan kids in Cuttack. He started the school Asha O Ashwana in Buxi Bazar area in 2000 to provide free education to kids from slums. The school was run from his earnings and tea stall. The school provided basic level education from kindergarten to third class for kids and later helped them to get enrolled in various government schools. His services were highlighted by Prime Minister Narendra Modi during radio address Man Ki Baat. All right, so Prime Minister Narendra Modi also addressed his social work that was doing a good work for the community. So he is D. Prakash Rao, social worker, Padma Shri in 2019, worked toward education for slum and orphan kids in Cuttack. Asha Ashwana was a school started by him from kindergarten. This is from kindergarten to third class students. All right, so moving on to next. नेक्स्ट विल बी डिस्कसिंग अ लेजेंडरी क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियन उस्ताद गुलाम मुस्तफा खान जी. आई रिपीट, उस्ताद गुलाम मुस्तफा खान जी इज रिलेटेड टू क्लासिकल म्यूजिक. ही वॉज अ रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ 3 पद्मा अवार्ड्स, दैट इज पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. सो डू रिमेंबर दीज थिंग्स, दीज आर द क्वेश्चन दैट हैव बीन आस्क्ड अर्लियर. ऑल राइट, उस्ताद गुलाम मुस्तफा खान, ही इज रिलेटेड टू विच फील्ड? ही इज रिलेटेड टू क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियन. ऑल राइट, ही इज अ क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियन. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सेकेंड, वॉट आर क्वेश्चन विल बी लाइक, फोर ऑप्शन विल बी गिवन एंड और इट कैन बी आस्क लाइक, ही इज अ रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ विच पद्मा अवार्ड्स? ही इज अ रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ 3 पद्मा अवार्ड्स दैट आर पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. ऑल राइट, सो दीज आर द अवार्ड्स दैट ही हैज बीन ऑनर्ड विद. सो इफ वी लुक एट सम ऑफ द की पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग हिम, उस्ताद गुलाम मुस्तफा खान, लेजेंडरी इंडियन क्लासिकल वोकलिस्ट एंड म्यूजिशियन, पास्ड अवे एट द एज ऑफ 89 इन मुंबई, महाराष्ट्र. ही वॉज अ रियॉन्ड वोकलिस्ट एंड अ म्यूजिशियन ऑफ रामपुर शाशवाना घराना ऑफ हिंदुस्तानी क्लासिकल म्यूजिक. ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन March 3, 1931 इन बदाऊं इन उत्तर प्रदेश. ही इज रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. सो दिस इज योर उस्ताद गुलाम मुस्तफा खान एंड ही इज रिलेटेड टू क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियन. ऑल राइट, एंड ही इज अ रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ 3 पद्मा अवार्ड्स, पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. नेक्स्ट द पर्सन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, सो हायर चांस ऑफ बींग आस्क्ड. शी इज डॉक्टर वी शांता. डॉक्टर वी शांता इज ऑल्सो रिसिपिटेंट ऑफ 3 पद्मा अवार्ड्स, पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. शी इज अ चेयरपर्सन ऑफ कैंसर इंस्टीट्यूट इन चेन्नई, तमिलनाडु एंड शी इज अ ऑनकोलॉजिस्ट, दैट मीन्स शी डील्स विद कैंसर एंड ट्यूमर रिलेटेड एलिमेंट्स. इफ वी लुक एट डॉक्टर वी शांता, शी इज अ 3 पद्मा अवार्डी रेसिपिटेंट. शी इज पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. सो शी इज अ रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ ऑल दीज 3 पद्मा अवार्ड्स. शी इज अ चेयरपर्सन ऑफ द कैंसर इंस्टीट्यूट, चेयरपर्सन ऑफ कैंसर इंस्टीट्यूट चेन्नई. ऑल राइट, एंड शी इज एन ऑनकोलॉजिस्ट, दैट मीन्स शी डील्स विद कैंसर और ट्यूमर रिलेटेड डिजीज. ऑल राइट, डॉक्टर वी शांता. डॉक्टर वी शांता इज अ रियॉन्ड इंडियन ऑनकोलॉजिस्ट, चेयरमैन ऑफ कैंसर इंस्टीट्यूट चेन्नई, तमिलनाडु. शी पास्ड अवे एट द एज ऑफ 93 इन चेन्नई. शी इज द रेसिपिटेंट ऑफ पद्मश्री, पद्मा भूषण एंड पद्मा विभूषण. शी वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 11th May 1927 इन चेन्नई इटसेल्फ. शी इज अ वेल नोन फॉर हर एंडेवर्स टू प्रोवाइड एसेसिबिलिटी टू गुड क्वालिटी एंड अफोर्डेबल ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ फॉर कैंसर टू ऑल द पेशेंट्स इन इंडिया. ऑल राइट, सो शी इज योर डॉक्टर वी शांता. Next we'll be discussing Narendra Chanchal ji. Remember, Narendra Chanchal ji is a famous bhajan singer. I repeat, he is a famous bhajan singer who recently passed away. Just remember, this is the question that can be framed from him is, who is the famous bhajan singer recently passed away? He is Narendra Chanchal ji. Next and the last question for our video, or the last person that we'll be discussing in this video is Cloris Leachman. She is an Oscar and an Emmy Award winner. I repeat, Oscar and Emmy Award winner. She is Cloris Leachman. All right, she is an Hollywood actor. Cloris Leachman. She is a Hollywood actor. All right, and she is a winner of Oscar and Emmy winner. All right, Emmy award. These are the most important awards or the most biggest award in the Hollywood industry. And also remember an autobiography of her. That is, the name of the autobiography is Cloris, My Autobiography. This is the autobiography of Cloris Leachman. Okay, so if we look at some of the points, an American actress and comedian, Oscar awardee, Emmy winning actress, Cloris Leachman passed away at the age of 94 in California. She released her autobiography titled Cloris, My Autobiography. All right, just remember these three things about him: autobiography name, Oscar and Emmy winner, and she's an Hollywood actress, Cloris Leachman. All right, so she is the person. So friends, this was our video. I hope you enjoyed our video. If you liked our video, do hit the like button, share the link with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, or if you are new to our channel, then do subscribe, because it motivates us to bring a better content for you guys. Also, if you have any trouble regarding login or payment or any other issues, then you can reach to us on our mail, that is support@affairscloud.com, or you can call us on the number 9677333862 and we'll resolve your issue as soon as possible. Also, you should go and check our courses that are available at a very reasonable price, and that will help you to boost your preparations for upcoming government exams. You can use the code VIKAS10 to get a straight 10% discount on any purchase you make. Alright, so that's all for the day. Take care.